Hello viewers, and welcome to another webinar on commodity derivatives. Today we will be discussing trading journey for a new customer, and we'll also dwell upon different links and tabs which will help those who have been trading in commodities. Today we have with us Mr. Jitendra Kumar Patle, product manager commodities and currencies at ICICI Securities, who will run through the presentation on trading journey. Welcome, Jitendra.
Hi, Ramesh. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Jitendra, there were a few questions from customers. I'm a new to commodity trading. Can you please guide me, where can I look at information on commodity markets?
Yeah. So right now I am on ICICIdirect.com homepage. Here we have a tab, equity, mutual fund, ETF, derivatives, currency and commodity. I will go to the commodity and I will show you the live demo, which information available where and how we can utilize it. So right now I am on the commodity by default market page, where I will get all commodity related live information. Like we can see here the commodity gold mini live price and other detail. Right hand side we have the chart also. Then below that we have the commodity brokerage calculator. With the help of this brokerage calculator, we can compute the cost, expected cost for particular transaction. Like here we have given the by default gold regular contract, and suppose I am purchasing at 47,503 and selling at 47,741, then what would be my cost for one lot? So trade value would be almost 95 lakh rupees. Brokerage would be the 40 rupees, that is 20 rupees buy, 20 rupees sell. And there are other charges just like exchange transaction charge, SEBI charge, GST, STT, CTT. CTT means commodity transaction tax, then stamp duty. So if I add all these charges, my total cost would be 923 rupees. Means to get into profit, that this commodity gold should move by 10 rupees. So in 10 rupees, I would be in a profitable, that is my break even point, and I will earn 23,000, approximately 23,000 with this selling price. Similarly, right hand side, we have MCX Bullion Index and Metal Index calculator, where I can get the similar information. I'm going down. On same page, we have the live market statistics on commodities, like top gainer, top loser, active commodities by value, active commodities by volume, and other commodity live news at bottom of the page. So this information is available on commodity market page. Also, we have the product page. I'm clicking on the product tab. You can see after the market page, on product tab, we have the various information commodity derivatives. Like here you can see the reports, that is the monthly research report, means this report gives the insight on commodities for the particular month. Then we also have the daily report, which comes every day morning around 8:30 a.m. and which talks about what happened yesterday in international and domestic market in commodities, what is the outlook for the day. So, and similarly, we have videos and podcast. There are a few videos which are in association with the MCX product manager, which is called as a commodity masterclass. Also, we have some product related videos on trade in commodity index future and other videos. Below that, we have some podcast that is on commodity yearly outlook, monthly outlook. If somebody want to understand commodity in Hindi, then we have the one podcast on commodity in Hindi on basics of commodities. Below that, we have those few question and answers, that is a frequently asked question. We can get some information from this page.
Okay. Yes, this gives basic information on commodity markets. Can you just help, like how can a new customer register and activate his commodity derivatives account?
Yeah, so it is very simple. It is completely online process. Another thing I want to highlight, there is no charges of opening commodity account in ICICI Direct if you have existing ICICI Direct account. So how we can activate? Now the commodity trading is available on ICICI Direct, this website, as well as mobile app, ICICI Direct mobile app. So I am logging to the current ICICI Direct account, and I will show you how we can activate commodity account. Just a second. Yeah, so after login, I will get by default equity page. And suppose I am new to the commodity, then I click on commodity tab. You can see portfolio, mutual fund, F&O, after that commodity. I will get this terms and condition page where I need to read and I need to accept this terms and condition. And after accepting this terms and condition, I will get another page on mandatory communication details. This is the additional page for commodities, where the list of commodities will be available and I need to select the preference for commodities. In case I am not involved in any kind of business or production of any commodity, I need to select others. And by default, we have given selection on others. And then you need to click on update button at the bottom. Now question comes, after doing this process, when will my commodity account will get activated? So the commodity account will get activated in one working day. You will get the official confirmation through mail and SMS on your register mail ID and mobile number.
Yeah, this was very informative. Jitendra, can you just explain now? I have understood about commodity markets. I have done my registration and activated my commodity segment. Now, how can I place order, look at my positions, mark to market, etc.?
Yeah. So this is the commodity home page. Under this sub menu bar, we have the various features just like portfolio, place order, allocate fund. The last option is commodity list. I just wanted to show you which are the commodities available for trading. These are the commodities available for trading right from the aluminum, copper, nickel, zinc. And you can see the lot size and view margin. Now on same bar, same menu bar, we have the place order button. When I will click on place order, I need to put the underline. Underline means the contract in which I wanted to trade. Just like I want to trade in gold petal. So I am selecting the gold petal, then I need to select the contract. Now there are on the basis of the liquidity, the contract will be enabled. Like right now we have the August and September contract. Suppose I want to buy the August contract. Right now the price is going on around 4759. In case I want to get other detail like what is the opening price, high, low today, I can get from this LTP. And here I can see open, high, low, close. Now I wanted to trade, then I need to enter the quantity. Quantity can be entered by two way. One is that I can enter the quantity just like gold mini. I take the example of gold mini where the lot size is 100 gram. So I can enter 100 and by default lot would become a lot, one lot would be visible here. But here the for gold better lot size is 1 gram. So I can put one here, so automatically one will come in lot. Now after that, I need to enter my desired price. In case I want to purchase at market price, just I need to click on market and then I can submit. Or in case I want to place my price at suppose 4750 or something, so I can put that. Right now I'm entering the market price. I'm entering market price and clicking on buy. Now, after that, I will get the verification page. On verification page, I will get all other information for verification, like what is the price I have entered, what is the quantity I have entered, which contract I have selected. After final proceed, I will get auto pop-up for fund allocation. In case I have allocated the sufficient fund in commodity, then I will not get this pop-up. But in case the additional fund is required, I will get that pop-up. I just need to submit and my order will get placed in exchange. Now I got confirmation that your order has been sent to the exchange. Now the question comes, where I can see my order, where I can see my trades, how I can track my position. Here is the order book option. Here also you can get from menu bar also. Now you can see here your both the orders. Means I have placed right now the one market order that is executed. And one more order I have earlier placed that is cancelled. So all order, even including historical order, I can select here the period and I can see the historical order. Now I want to check what is my traded price, trade price and trade value. So here I can get this detail from trade book. Even in case I want to check what is my brokerage and taxes, so that would be available after the end of the day. But for historical trades, we can see the brokerage and taxes in this brokerage and taxes column. So this way I can check my position. Now the most important part of trading I am coming to, that is the open position. Now I have taken the position. Okay. Now I want to check what is the profit and loss on that position, or I want to stare up that position. So where I can do that? So this is available on open position page. So on open position page, I can see my open position, contract description, then quantity, then what is my purchase price, that is average price, then what is against that LTP is going on, all those details would be available here. Another one feature we have given here, the trigger price. Trigger price means what? Below, in case I have the buy position, and right now the price is 4760, but in case my position goes unfavorable side, and it goes below the 4718, then my position may get into risk management, RMS system. It means that my position may get squared up if my margin is insufficient. Now, how my margin will get insufficient? Now, here, the last two column I need to see. One is that available margin and minimum margin. I need to always maintain my available margin, that is 4.8. My available margin should be always greater than minimum margin. Margin means based on this minimum margin we have derived at this trigger price, and my available margin should be greater than minimum margin. Now in case my position goes at unfavorable side, then whatever the notional loss would be there, that will get deducted from available margin, and in case that loss is greater than that below the minimum margin level, then my position may get square up. Now question comes, how I can avoid that? How I can avoid the system square up? So for that, what I need to do, I need to go to the allocate fund. I need to keep an extra margin. Like right now, the 4.8 rupees margin required. I can allocate additional 500 rupees in my commodity section. And then in case my position goes below the minimum margin, system will automatically pull the margin from allocation and my position will get squared up. But remember, ICICI Direct cannot take fund from bank accounts and other segments. We get many queries that I had a sufficient fund in my bank account, but we cannot touch your bank account. So this way I can track my position. In case I want to square up my position, here is the square up button. Square up means closing the position. I can click here and I can square up my position. So this way I can do all my trades.
Okay. Jitendra, commodity markets are traded almost for 14 and a half to 15 hours in a day. And yeah, there are international agri commodities which get traded till 9 o'clock, and other international commodities till 11:30 or 11:55. Okay. Now, can you explain what are all the support that ICICI Direct has? Like, how can I track my market? Where can I look at research report? Are there any research recommendations available? Research reports and research recommendations? Yeah. In case yes, can you just show where all I can look at that?
Yes. Okay. So I'm again going back to the commodity homepage, where all this information and the research reports are available. Like you can see left hand side, daily commodity strategy. These reports come early in the morning around 8:30 a.m. and we provide the information regarding what happened yesterday in commodity market internationally and domestically. Then what is expected today, what are the events are scheduled today. All this information available under this daily commodity strategy report. Now, after that, we have the various podcasts, like one podcast on basics of commodities. Then the right hand side, we have the one podcast on monthly commodity derivative research outlook for ongoing month. Then after that, most important is I click to gain page. What is this? This is the live recommendation page. Here we provide the live recommendation for all the segment, including equity, currency, commodity. So this is the common page where I can select the commodity future and I can see the what are the live recommendation available for commodity. Like here we have the crude oil recommendation given around 1 p.m. So we can see this recommendation from this page. I'm going back to the again the home page where we also have the monthly commodity derivative report, that is again the outlook for the ongoing month. Then we have a special commodity report section where any special report is there, that would be visible. Again, after that, in case you want to understand commodity market in more detail, here is under the need assistance section, we have the commodity presentation. Under commodity presentation, we can see all the information related to commodity market, what is commodity market, what is the history of commodity market, then which are the global exchanges, which are the Indian exchanges, which are the commodities trading, and various other information is available here. You can refer from this page. Also, we have the how to trade in commodity presentation. This presentation talks about again what I am explaining right now, again regarding the how to activate commodity account or how to trade. So this all support is available here.
Okay, that's very exhaustive information available. Jitendra, can you explain on the reports, like the P&L report, what all I can get, or can I get a quarterly report, statements on what all have been my transactions? If at all, you can just show that where are they available?
Yeah. So on the basis of expiry date, you can check your profit and loss for open and close position under portfolio link. This is the first link we have on this page, where you can see the you can select the period based on the expiry date, and you can check the profit and loss. Just like I have selected, I can see all the profit and loss for my historical as well as open position. The open position profit and loss will be showing in this unrealized column, just like I have the 1 rupees loss in current position, and all the closed position profit and loss will be visible in the realized column. So here I can see, and a total of both would be available in this total column. But apart from that, we have the ready-made statements for trading in, to checking the profit and loss in other transaction. So here I can click on this plus button and I will get other menus. And last menu is commodity profit and loss statement. Here I can get the commodity profit and loss statement for particular financial year. I can select any financial year and I can get the profit and loss statement. I can download in PDF Excel format, that is also available. Only thing, this report will be available after 3:30 p.m. on trading days. Then also we have that commodity transaction statement report. In case you want to see the commodity transaction statement, that report is also available here.
Okay. That was very exhaustive presentation, Jitendra. Dear viewers, hope this was useful and this will help you to do better trades in commodity derivatives. Keep watching this space for more content and more videos. Thank you. Yeah, thanks, Jitendra.
Thank you very much.
Investments in securities market are subject to market risks. Read all related documents carefully before investing.